So now that I have a good understanding of do-get, let's take this web server to the next level with some post functionality. Gets are good for viewing information already on the server, but posts are what allow the user to customize their web experience. Get requests happen simply by visiting a URL in a browser, but post requests from a browser require data to be submitted, like with a form.
I'm going to add a post method such that our server doesn't just say hello or hola, but whatever the user prompts as a salutation. On the same level as my doGet method, I'll create another method called doPost, which overrides the method in the base HTTP request handler superclass, just like doGet. I'll make another try accept block, similar to my doGet methods. When I receive a post request, I'll send off the response code that indicates a successful post. Next, I need to decipher the message that was sent from the server. In order to do this, I'm going to use some message from the CGI, or Common Gateway Interface, library in Python. So I'll add import CGI to the top of my file. Let's take a look at the following chunk of code I'm going to add. This cgi.parseHeader function parses an HTML form header, such as content type, into a main value and dictionary of parameters. After that, we check and see if this is form data being received. I then make a variable called fields, which will use the cgi.parseMultiParse to collect all of the fields in a form. Then, I will make a variable called messageContent to get out the value of a specific field or set of fields and store them in an array. I will call this field message here, and when I create my HTML form. So now that I've received a post request, I can decide what to tell the client with the new information I've received. I will create an empty string named output again, and then add some opening HTML tags to it. I'll have my server respond with, "Okay, how about this?" and then return the first value of the array that was created when I submitted the form. Well, you might be thinking, "Hey, you haven't even created an HTML form, but keep talking about it in the post handler." And you'd be right, so I'll go ahead and do that now. In this line of HTML code, I'm adding a post request along with a header tag to prompt the user to input some data. Here, I wrote the name of my input field as message to coincide with the message field I'm extracting data from in the post request. I'm going to copy this line of code and paste it into my hello and hola get request, so this form will be present on their pages as well. I will also separate out my opening and closing HTML tags on their own line of code. Let me not forget to close the body and HTML tags in my post handler, send the output out to the server, and print out the output for debugging. In my exception block, I will just leave it as pass for now. Let's see these new changes in action from the web browser.